We are back on Saturday night, and the countdown is on. Ladies and gentlemen, later on in this telecast, we are going to take you back to WCW Monday Nitro. We're going to show you what has to go down as one of the most startling events in the history of Nitro since we took the air back Labor Day of 1995.
And we took the air under the leadership of one Eric Bischoff.
Yes, he was the man. He was the voice of Nitro.
Yeah,
he was the voice of WCW. And what has happened now?
Yeah, the visionary that he is. Envisioned this and brought it to pass. But somewhere along the line, there's a smell that only that deodorant can't take off. And the smell is, I really believe we're gonna, you know, try to find out, and we'll talk about it and dot all the I's, is there seems to be a problem with why he didn't want to sign this thing with Pipe and Hogan too. I mean, why did this not want to be done? So much at stake. Bottom line, going back to the leader, the man is Hulk Hogan. Beating him, this thing starts to even out. That's what you gotta do. So stop crying about it. Somebody needs to beat Hollywood Hulk Hogan, Hulkamania himself. He's the man. This guy right here, fine athlete Jeff Jarrett. Now then, I see, is he official horseman? Is he a member of the Four Horsemen?
I don't think he's officially a member of the Horsemen now.
Oh, he's just in there.
Ric Flair, of course, is not able to compete.
And Flair endorsed him.
Oh, we do understand Flair's going to be in Baltimore as well.
Tonight?
Tonight. He's
in
not
some capacity.
That's right.
Well, that's, you know, me being legendary reporter that I am, I had to drag that out of you.
You did. All right, Jeff Jarrett and Mean Mike Enos.
I like this matchup.
Yeah, I do too.
But I think Mike Enos can beat anybody at any time, and Jeff Jarrett the same way. This is something like you would see somewhere in you know, in some big arena somewhere. This is a big matchup here on Saturday Night, the Mothership.
And Jeff Jarrett.
Strut.
Little strutting contest going on here, a little showboating to begin things, and we're about ready to go.
I used to go with a girl that wore drawers like that. They had fringe on them hanging down like that.
Did you really?
Yes, I did. Down in South Texas.
I bet you did.
I did. Every Friday night, she'd be like that at the football game.
Trying to double axe handle blow. And then a headbutt, and Mike Enos goes in with reckless abandon and pays for it.
Yes.
Right hand to the side of the head.
That was a nice shot right there. And he's got a tough man, a reeling right here. I'm talking about one Jeff Jarrett. Now, as he starts to strut, don't take his mind off of Mike Enos. I guarantee you, the bad meanness of Dick Slater had to rub off on Mike Enos.
I think so, too, and there's a mean streak in Mike Enos
anyway,
as well.
Anyway.
That's right.
Yeah, sting in the rafters. Come down. Deal your hand. World War III, 60-man, three-ring battle royal. One man will meet the world's heavyweight champion. Hulk Hogan, Piper, contract. I'll be there. You be there. We all going to be there.
Sting seems to be doing a lot of watching when Jeff Jarrett's around him. Notice that?
Well,
he attacked him a couple of weeks ago.
Yeah, I was getting ready to say he did more than watch him.
But since then, every time Jeff Jarrett either wrestles or does an interview, there you see Sting. We have a Sting sighting in the arena somewhere every time Jeff Jarrett's around.
Okay.
When Jeff Jarrett faces the Giant tomorrow night, will Sting make an appearance again?
Well, I hope Sting's there, period. He, like I said earlier, needs to deal with him one way or the other. Now, if you brought up something there that all the fans are out there saying right now, Dustin, why don't you ask him, Dream, ask Tony about this. You just brought this up. They're sitting there watching TV, want me to ask you, well, maybe Sting wants to be a member of the Horsemen, not the NWO, and Jarrett is a standing in his way.
Good point again.
You know, at home, they screaming for me to say that.
You just fooled.
But that's
a
true
point,
right? Is that right?
Yes.
Maybe that's the point. Maybe he don't want nothing to do with the NWO.
No one has been able to talk to him very mysteriously, and we have shown you on our Nitro footage, Sting approached Luger with that baseball bat.
Yeah.
Kind of shoved him around with it. Don't know what
and
it's all about.
And handed it to him.
And handed it to him.
Yeah.
What was he saying? Use it? Or if I turn my back, hit me with it? Let's see if you're man enough. You don't know.
I mean, you just don't know.
And obviously, when Eric Bischoff did what he did at the end of Nitro, I said
we
to myself,
used the bat. Give me the bat.
No. I didn't say that.
Oh, what'd you say?
I said, we just don't know.
Yeah, we don't.
We just never know.
I said, give me the bat. Yeah, you walked. Everybody booed you. Hurt my mama feeling. Well, Eric out there dealing. Piper come out. Call him a ball face lie.
Oh.
Man, I tell you what. Oh. I've never seen my industry in such an uproar as it is right now, and I'm talking about pro wrestling.
We've never
because
seen
there's only one pro wrestling, that is WCW, with a big boy play.
There you go.
Nothing in this industry has ever captivated a country or imagination like this is right now. I guarantee you. You know, he goes strut once too often, and yes. Mike Enos is going to kick him right in the hind end.
Whoa!
Unless he gets beat early.
A swinging neck breaker. Nicely done by Jeff Jarrett. Jeff Jarrett reversal. Enos sending Jarrett in.
Now, big power slam.
Slam!
Oh! He caught him on the knee. He got that knee underneath in there, Tony. Did you see that?
I sure did.
Did you see that?
And that's going to give him the open door to maybe go to the figure four leg lock.
Yeah, more than that, I think Mike Enos might have a broken kneecap because he caught that. That was a real nasty-looking move right there.
Have you ever seen that ever?
No, that was nasty. He got his leg caught under there. That's like watching the guy get his knee bent back. That was a nasty move. He's in a lot of pain and hurt right here. Be lucky, Jeff Jarrett, you got out of this one.
I'm sure Jeff will take luck as well as being good, and he is both. Jeff Jarrett is a great wrestler and a winner, and Jeff Jarrett now, we know how ready he is for the Giant.
Yeah.
He said, you're not going to choke slam me. The Giant says, I will, and we will find out tomorrow night. Jeff, of course, one of the 60 men to compete in the three-ring over-the-top rope Battle Royal Dusty Rhodes.
Good matchup right here. Jeff Jarrett, though, really strutting around the ring there, doing his thing. Bottom line, Mike Enos went for a power slam, got his knee caught under it, into a situation where the figure four come into play. Enos in a lot of pain. Jeff Jarrett on the way to the pay window right here on the mothership on Saturday night as we get ready for World War III, only on pay-per-view.
Still to come, Regal against Malenko, and we take you back to Nitro as well. But right now in the locker room, Mean Gene.
You know, I had an opportunity to sit back here for a couple of months and observe a lot of things now back in WCW, but I was so impressed the way this young man hit his stride so quick at World Championship Wrestling.
Oh, yeah.
Double J. Yes, Jeff Jarrett, come on in. It was just a month ago that you met the awesome Giant at Halloween Havoc. You know how big and powerful this man is. Now coming up tomorrow night at World War III, the rematch, and I know you're chomping at the bit.
Exactly, Gene. I'm going to let the cat out of the bag. Everybody knows that Halloween Havoc, I went into the match, and I guaranteed that I would not be chokeslammed. And now the Giant, he has gone to WCW offices. He has begged a match. That's right, the Giant, the man who has put down Hulk Hogan, Ric Flair, the list goes on and on, Arne Anderson, all the Four Horsemen, all the Dungeon of Doom. He chokeslammed them all, but he didn't get me at Halloween Havoc. And at World War III, Gene, I get the shot at the Daily Double. Giant, I've said it before, and I'll say it again. I'm going to chop you down to size, and then I'm going to get to Hogan. And then the big 60-man battle royal, right, Gene?
Yes, three rings and 60 of the very best in all of professional wrestling. I'm very curious, though. Jeff, any words from the nature boy Ric Flair regarding you and the Giant?
Oh, you saw him on Monday night. Me and Flair were strutting our stuff, walking the walk and talking the talk, and that's what we're going to do tomorrow night. Oh, World War III. I cannot wait. 60 men go in, one man left standing, and it's going to be me.
Highly motivated. He's going to have a great, great presence tomorrow night, World War III, exclusively on pay-per-view. Jeff Jarrett, and we're right back. Don't go away.